This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. MSNBC is an American basic cable and satellite television network that provides news coverage and political commentary from NBC News on current events. The network also carries a nightly opinion programming block during prime time hours. It is owned by the NBC Universal News Group, a unit of the NBC Universal Television Group division of NBC Universal, all of which are owned by Comcast. MSNBC and MSNBC.com were founded in 1996 as a partnership between Microsoft and General Electric's NBC unit, hence the network's naming. Although they shared the same name, MSNBC.com and MSNBC maintained separate corporate structures and news operations, with MSNBC.com headquartered on the West Coast on the Microsoft campus in Redmond, Washington, and MSNBC in the NBC headquarters in New York. Microsoft divested its stake in the MSNBC channel in 2005, and divested its stake in MSNBC.com in July 2012, rebranding the general news site as NBC News.com and creating a new MSNBC.com as the online home of the cable news channel as of February 2015. Approximately 94,531,000 households, 812% of those with television, have the ability to receive MSNBC within the United States of America. In the late summer of 2015, MSNBC revamped its programming. The moves were in sharp contrast to previous programming decisions at the network, with the entire lineup of opinionated afternoon programming being canceled. Along with this, moves were made to sharpen the channel's news image through a dual editorial relationship with its organizational parent NBC News. MSNBC Live, the network's flagship daytime news platform, was expanded to cover over 8 hours of the day. Phil Griffin currently serves as the president and director of day-to-day operations at the cable network. Pat Burkey and Janelle Rodriguez oversee programming and news operations at the network, with Brian Williams serving as the channel's chief anchor and managing editor of breaking news coverage. Contents 1 History 11 Development 12 Early History 13-2008-2015-14 Return to Hard News and Go Beyond Campaign Campaign 2015 Present 2 Notable Personalities 3 Carriage Issues 4 International Broadcasts 41 MSNBC Canada 42 MSNBC Africa 43 Middle East and North Africa 44 Europe and Asia 45 NTV MSNBC 5 Online 51 Shift 6 Radio 7 Criticism and Controversy 71 Liberal Bias 72 Favoritism Towards Barack Obama 73 Phil Donahue Dismissal 74 Rise of the New Right Documentary 75 Romney Coverage During 2012 Election 76 Coverage of Financial Issues 77 Romney Family Grandchild 78 Anti-Israel Bias 79 Suspensions of Host 791 Michael Savage 792 Don Imus 793 Keith Olbermann 794 Martin Bashir 795 Alec Baldwin 8 References 9 Sources 10 External Links History Development MSNBC was established by NBC executive Tom Rogers. Rogers was instrumental in developing the strategic partnership with Microsoft, which invested $221 million for a 50% share of the cable channel. MSNBC and Microsoft would share the cost of a $200 million newsroom in Secaucus, New Jersey. For MSNBC.com, the network took over the channel space of NBC's 18-month-old America's Talking Network, though in most cases cable carriage had to be negotiated with providers who never carried it. Early history. Former MSNBC logo used from 1996 until 2009. The N in the logo was changed from red to black in 2002. This variant has occasionally been used after 2006 as an alternative logo in a horizontal form. Main article, History of MSNBC, 1996-2007. MSNBC was launched on July 15, 1996. The first show, which was anchored by Jody Applegate, broadcast a lineup of news, interviews, and opinions during the day. Rolling news coverage continued with The Contributors, a show that featured Ann Coulter and Laura Ingram, as well as interactive programming coordinated by Applegate, John Gibson, and John Siegenthaler. Stories were generally longer and more detailed than the stories running on CNN at the time. NBC also highlighted their broadcast connections by airing stories direct from the NBC network affiliates, along with breaking news coverage from the same sources. Gradually, MSNBC began to put more emphasis on politics. The Project for Excellence in Journalism found in 2007, after a 7-year survey of cable channels, that MSNBC is moving to make politics a brand, with a large dose of opinion and personality. In January 2001, Mike Barnicle got a show on MSNBC, but it was cancelled in June 2001 due to high production costs in June. In a sign of continuing trouble at MSNBC, Microsoft CEO Steve Ballmer said that he would not have started MSNBC if he knew then what he knows now, referencing the long-standing troubles attracting viewers after the September 11, 2001 attacks. MSNBC served as an outlet for NBC News to provide up-to-the-minute coverage, in contrast to broadcast NBC's longer stories. CNBC and CNBC Europe, with little financial news to report, ran MSNBC for many hours of the day following the attacks. The year also boosted the profile of Ashley Banfield, who was present during the collapse of Building 7 while covering the World Trade Center on September 11. Her Region in Conflict program capitalized on her newfound celebrity and showcased exclusive interviews from Afghanistan on December 23, 2005. It was announced that NBC Universal would acquire an additional 32% share of the television channel from Microsoft, solidifying its control over television operations and allowing NBC to further consolidate MSNBC's backroom operations with NBC News and its other cable properties. The news website MSNBC.com remained a separate joint venture between Microsoft and NBC for another 7 years. NBC would have the option, which it exercised, to buy the remaining 18% share of the television from Microsoft after 2 years. MSNBC, along with other U.S. news networks, had been criticized for having a distorted and biased media coverage of the Iraq War. The network began from 2005 onward to attract liberal and progressive viewers when host Keith Olbermann began critiquing and satirizing conservative media commentators on his program Countdown with Keith Olbermann. Olbermann especially focused his attention to Fox News Channel and its main primetime commentator, Bill O'Reilly. On June 7, 2006, Rick Kaplan resigned as president of MSNBC, after holding the post for 2 years following the announcement. It was announced on June 12, 2006, that Dan Abrams, a 9-year veteran of MSNBC and NBC News, had been named general manager of MSNBC, effective immediately. NBC News senior vice president Phil Griffin would oversee MSNBC, while also continuing to oversee NBC News Today, and Abrams would report to Griffin on June 29, 2006. Abrams announced a revamp to MSNBC's early primetime and primetime schedule on July 10. Tucker, formerly The Situation with Tucker Carlson, started airing at 4 p.m. and 6 p.m. Eastern Time, taking over Abrams' old timeslot, while Rita Cosby's Live Studios. NBC essentially merged its entire news operation into one building, and all MSNBC broadcasts, as well as NBC Nightly News, originate from the new studios. More than 125 hours of live television across the NBC News family originate from the New York studios daily. MSNBC has also announced new studios near the Universal Studios lot. MSNBC's master control did not make the move to 30 Rock. It remained in the old Secaucus headquarters until it completed its move to the NBC Universal Network Origination Center, located inside the CNBC Global Headquarters building in Englewood Cliffs, New Jersey. On December 21, 2007, shortly thereafter, Major League Baseball firmed up a long-term lease of the former MSNBC building to become the home studios of MLB Network, which launched from the facility on January 1, 2009, 2008 to 2015. MSNBC logo used from 2009 to 2015. The current logo is a variant of this design. Main article, History of MSNBC, 2008 to 2015. From mid-2007 to mid-2008, MSNBC received a large increase in its ratings. Primetime viewings increased by 61% over that time. In May 2008, NBC News president Steve Capus said that it used to be people didn't have to worry about MSNBC because it was an also-ran cable channel. That's not the case anymore. Tim Russert's sudden death in June 2008 removed what the Wall Street Journal called the rudder for the network and led to a period of transition. During the 2008 presidential election, MSNBC's coverage was anchored by Keith Olbermann, Chris Matthews and David Gregory. The three were widely viewed as the face of the channel's political coverage during the first 3 months of the presidential campaign. MSNBC's ratings grew by 158%. However, during the election coverage, anchors Keith Olbermann and Chris Matthews were criticized for expressing left-leaning viewpoints on the channel, and both of them were later removed from the position of anchor. Audience viewership during the 2008 presidential election more than doubled from the 2004 presidential election, and the channel topped CNN in ratings for the first time during the last 3 months of the campaign in the key 25-54 age demographic. In September 2008, the channel hired political analyst and Air America radio personality Rachel Maddow to host a new political opinion program called The Rachel Maddow Show. The move to create a new program for the channel was widely seen as a smart ratings move, where beforehand, MSNBC lagged behind in coveted primetime ratings. The show regularly outperformed CNN's Larry King Live, and made the channel competitive in the program's time slot for the first time in over a decade. In the first quarter of 2010, MSNBC beat CNN in primetime and overall ratings, marking the first time doing so since 2001. The channel also beat CNN in total adult viewers in March, marking the seventh out of the past 8 months that MSNBC achieved that result in. Addition, the programs Morning Joe, The Ed Show, Hardball with Chris Matthews, Countdown with Keith Olbermann, and The Rachel Maddow Show all finished ahead of their time slot competitors on CNN in the third quarter of 2010. MSNBC continued its solid lead over CNN, beating the network in total day for the first time since 2Q2001 in the key adult demographic. The network also beat CNN for the fourth consecutive quarter, among both primetime and total viewers, as well as becoming the only cable news network to have its key adult demographic viewership grow over the last quarter, increasing by 4% during this time. MSNBC also became the number one cable news network in primetime among both African American and Hispanic viewers on October 11, 2010. MSNBC unveiled a new televised advertising campaign and slogan called "Lean Forward, We've Taken on CNN and We Beat Them." MSNBC President Phil Griffin told employees at a series of celebratory town hall meetings, "Now it's time to take on Fox." Concerning the campaign, Griffin said, "It is active, it is positive, it is about making tomorrow better than today, a discussion about politics and the actions and passions of our time." The new campaign embraces the network's politically progressive identity. The two-year advertising campaign would cost $2 million and consist of internet, television, and print advertising. The new positioning has created brand image issues for MSNBC.com, the umbrella website for the television network. A New York Times article quotes Charlie Tillinghast, president of MSNBC.com, a separate company, as saying, "Both strategies are fine, but naming them the same thing is brand insanity." As a result, MSNBC.com eventually changed its name to prevent confusion with the television network, MSNBC. It rebranded the more news-driven MSNBC.com as NBC News.com in July 2012. On January 21, 2011, Keith Olbermann announced his departure from MSNBC, and the episode would be the final episode of Countdown. His departure received much media attention. MSNBC issued a statement that it had ended its contract with Olbermann, with no further explanation. Olbermann later revealed that he had taken his show to Current TV during 2014. MSNBC's total ratings in the 25-54 age group declined 20%, falling to third place behind CNN. The only demographic in which MSNBC still leads is among Hispanics, and even more so among African Americans. Return to Hard News and Go Beyond campaign, 2015. Present in efforts to revive the struggling network, MSNBC underwent a transition from more left-leaning opinionated programming to hard news programming beginning in the summer of 2015. Nearly all daytime opinionated news programs were replaced with generic news programs. Ronan Farrow, Joy Reid, Crystal Ball, Torre, Ari Melber, Abby Huntsman, Alex Wagner, Ed Schultz and Al Sharpton all lost their weekday opinion shows news programs presented by well-established NBC. News personalities including Telemundo anchor José Díaz Ballard, Meet the Press anchor Chuck Todd, Sunday NBC Nightly News anchor Kate Snow, Thomas Roberts, and former NBC Nightly News anchor Brian Williams replaced Opinion shows a new on-air presentation debuted in late summer 2015, which included a new logo, a news ticker, as well as a new graphics package. MSNBC Live now takes up at least 8 hours of programming each day, barring any breaking news that could extend its time. Daytime news coverage is led primarily by Brian Williams, Stephanie Ruhle, José Díaz Ballard, Tamron Hall, Andrea Mitchell, Craig Melvin, Thomas Roberts, and Kate Snow, in addition to beat leaders located throughout the newsroom. These include Chief Legal Correspondent Ari Melber, Primary Political Reporter Steve Kurnatsky, Business and Finance Correspondent Olivia Stearns, and Senior Editor Cal Perry. Morning and primetime programming has not changed during this transition as it remains filled by mostly opinionated personalities. In April 2016, MSNBC launched a campaign of promotional ads with the theme, "In order to know beyond, you have to go beyond." The campaign attempts to portray MSNBC's reporting and perspectives as in-depth and an alternative to talking points coverage on other cable news outlets. In July 2016, the network debuted a new, abridged version of Dateline NBC, known as Dateline Extra, in yet another step to align MSNBC and NBC News. The new program is hosted by MSNBC Live anchor Tamron Hall. In September 2016, MSNBC launched The 11th Hour with Brian Williams as a nightly wrap-up for the news of the day and a preview of the following day's headlines. This is the first new primetime program on the network in nearly 4 years. Notable personalities: Peter Alexander, Mika Brzezinski, Robert Costa, José Díaz Ballard, Josh Barrow, Richard Engel, Willie Geist, Tamron Hall, Mark Halperin, Chris Hayes, John Heilman, Hugh Hewitt, Amy Holmes, Casey Hunt, Hallie Jackson, Jack H. Jacobs, Chris Jansing, Ezra Klein, Steve Kurnatsky, Trimaine Lee, Richard Louie, Rachel Maddow, Chris Matthews, Mark McKinnon, Ari Melber, Craig Melvin, Andrea Mitchell, Eamon Mohideen, Betty Nguyen, Kelly O'Donnell, Lawrence O'Donnell, J.J. Ramberg, Joy Ann Reed, Thomas Roberts, Eugene Robinson, Stephanie Ruhle, Joe Scarborough, Steve Schmidt, Al Sharpton, Jacob Soboroff, Kate Snow, Chuck Todd, Katie Turr, Ali Velshi, Nicole Wallace, Kristen Welker, Brian Williams, Alex Witt. Carriage issues: MSNBC's former New Jersey headquarters studio, now the home of MLB Network. Before 2010, MSNBC was not available to Verizon Fiosinet. Radio, Television and Telecommunications Commission authorized the American version to be carried on Canadian cable and satellite providers. The channel was operated by Rogers Communications and co-owned by Rogers, Shaw and MSNBC, with each party owning a 3,333% voting interest in the service. Programming included MSNBC programs as well as repeats of shows from the CBC and Cable Public Affairs Channel. As its way to fulfill its Canadian content requirements, the channel also ran infomercials, which the American service never shows. MSNBC Africa. In Southern Africa, MSNBC is distributed free to air on satellite on Free2View TV as MSNBC Africa, a joint venture between Great Media Limited and MSNBC. Free2View airs MSNBC's programming from 4 p.m. to midnight ET in a block that repeats twice live for the first airing, with local weather channel forecasts. Botswana's national television broadcaster, BTV, also provides an unedited broadcast of MSNBC, including advertisements after their scheduled programming each evening. BTV is available within Botswana, as well as to Southern Africa viewers on DSTV. TOPTV, a satellite TV service in South Africa, also provides an unedited broadcast of MSNBC, including advertisements, which runs 24 hours a day. It is also available in Kenya and Uganda through the cable service Zuku Middle East and North Africa. MSNBC programming is shown for almost the hour a day on the 24-hour news network OSN News Europe and Asia. In Asia and Europe, MSNBC is not shown on a dedicated channel. When MSNBC started in 1996, they announced plans to start broadcasting in Europe during 1997. This never happened. However, MSNBC was seen occasionally on affiliate channel CNBC Europe. MSNBC was shown overnight at the weekend and during the afternoon on American American public holidays as well as during breaking news events. MSNBC stopped being shown on CNBC Europe in the late 2000s, and coverage of non-business related breaking news now comes from CNBC US's own coverage or from NBC News. NTV MSNBC in Turkey. NTV MSNBC is the news channel of the Turkish broadcaster NTV Turkey. The channel is a joint partnership between the two, although very little Turkish content makes its way onto English. MSNBC English content on MSNBC is translated to Turkish online. MSNBC celebrated its 10th anniversary in 2006. NBC Newscom's main newsroom in Redmond, WA, 2007. NBC Newscom's newsroom in NYC, 2007. Main article, NBC Newscom. Launched concurrently with MSNBC was its website, MSNBC.com. Unlike the network itself, MSNBC.com was operated as the general online news outlet of NBC News. Partnering with Microsoft's MSN.com portal, the network and website also remained editorially separate. It did not adopt the network's increasingly liberal viewpoints, which itself was a cause for concern from NBC News staff, due to concerns that readers would think otherwise, and remained a joint venture with Microsoft even after it sold its stake in the MSNBC channel in July 2012. NBC acquired Microsoft's remaining stake in MSNBC.com, and rebranded it as NBC Newscom after being redirected to the new name for a period. MSNBC.com was relaunched in 2013 as a website for the network itself, focusing on content such as opinion columns from hosts, correspondents and guests, and both live and on-demand videos from MSNBC programs. Shift main article. Shift MSNBC. In July 2014, MSNBC.com launched MSNBC2, a brand for several web-only series hosted by MSNBC personalities. In December 2014, MSNBC2 was renamed Shift, with a programming schedule which is less focused on politics and is more tailored to a younger audience. Radio. The channel launched on XM Satellite Radio Channel 120 and Sirius Satellite Radio Channel 90. On April 12, 2010, this is the second time MSNBC has been available on satellite radio. The channel has been carried on XM before, but was subsequently dropped from the service on September 4, 2006. MSNBC programming is currently simulcast on SiriusXM Channel 118. Criticism and controversy. Main article, MSNBC controversies liberal bias. In November 2007, a New York Times article stated that MSNBC's primetime lineup is tilting more to the left. Commentators have since described MSNBC as having a bias towards left-leaning politics, and the Democratic Party. Washington Post media analyst Howard Kurtz has stated that the channel's evening lineup has clearly gravitated to the left in recent years and often seems to regard itself as the antithesis of Fox News, in reference to a number of journalists and political pundits considering Fox News to have a strong conservative bias. In 2011, Politico referred to MSNBC as left-leaning, and Steve Kornatsky of Salon.com noted that MSNBC's primetime lineup is now awash in progressive politics. In reference to changes in the channel's evening programming, Senior Vice President of NBC News Phil Griffin has said that it happened naturally. There isn't a dogma we're putting through, there is a go for it. In the February 2008 issue of Men's Journal magazine, a MSNBC interviewee quoted a senior executive who said that liberal commentator Keith Olbermann runs MSNBC and that because of his success, he's in charge of the channel. In 2007, the New York Times called Olbermann MSNBC's most recognizable face. In September 2008, MSNBC stated that they were removing both Keith Olbermann and Chris Matthews as live political event anchors, and replacing them with David Gregory, due to growing criticism that they were too opinionated to be seen as neutral in the heat of the presidential campaign. Olbermann continued to broadcast Countdown both before and after the presidential and vice presidential debates, and both Matthews and Olbermann joined Gregory on the channel's election night coverage on November 13, 2009. In the days leading up to the release of 2008 Republican vice presidential candidate Sarah Palin's book Going Rogue, MSNBC's Dylan Radigan used photoshopped pictures of Palin on the channel's morning meeting program. Radigan apologized a few days later. In October 2010, MSNBC began using the tagline "Lean Forward," which was described by some media outlets, including MSNBC.com, as the network embracing its politically progressive identity. In January 2012, MSNBC used Rachel Maddow Shadow, Chris Matthews, and other network commentators during coverage of the 2012 Iowa Republican caucuses, a move seen by Nando DeFino of the Mediaite website as giving up on the straight news coverage, and instead to be aiming to create some controversy. In November 2012, MSNBC was called the anti-Fox by the New York Times in a feature article that quoted former President Bill Clinton as saying, "Boy, it really has become our version of Fox." The article, citing data by the Nielsen TV ratings service, noted that while Fox News pulled in a larger overall viewership than MSNBC, the two networks were separated by only around 300,000 viewers among the 25-54 age bracket most attractive to advertisers in the Pew Research Center's 2013 State of the News Media report. MSNBC was found to be the most opinionated news network, with 85% of the content being commentary or opinions, and only 15% of the content being factual reporting. The report also stated that MSNBC spends the least amount of money producing its news, only $240 million in 2012, compared to CNN, which spent $682 million, and Fox, which spent $820 million. Favoritism towards Barack Obama. Some Democratic Party supporters, most notably former Democratic Governor of Pennsylvania Ed Rendell and Clinton advisor Lanny Davis, criticized MSNBC during and after the 2008 Democratic primaries, as covering Barack Obama more favorably than Hillary Clinton. Rendell said, "MSNBC was the official network of the Obama campaign," and called their coverage absolutely embarrassing. Rendell later became an on-air contributor to MSNBC. A study done by the Project for Excellence in Journalism showed that MSNBC had less negative coverage of Obama, 14% of stories versus 29% in the press overall, and more negative stories about Republican presidential candidate John McCain, 73% of its coverage versus 57% in the press overall. MSNBC's on-air slogan during the week of the 2008 presidential election, "The Power of Change," was criticized as being overtly similar to Obama's campaign slogan of "Hope and Change." Following the 2008 presidential election, conservative talk show host Jon Ziegler worked on a documentary titled "Media Malpractice: How Obama Got Elected," which was very critical of the media, especially MSNBC's role in the 2008 presidential election. While promoting the documentary, he engaged in an on-air dispute with MSNBC news anchor Contessa Brewer on how the media, especially MSNBC, had portrayed Sarah Palin during MSNBC's coverage of the Potomac primary. MSNBC's Chris Matthews said, "I have to tell you, you know, it's part of reporting this case, this election, the feeling most people get when they hear Barack Obama's speech. I felt this thrill going up my leg. I mean, I don't have that too often." This led Fox News to assert that both he and MSNBC were biased toward Obama. Phil Donahue dismissal difficult public face for NBC in a time of war. He seems to delight in presenting guests who are anti-war, anti-Bush, and skeptical of the administration's motives. NBC internal study. See also, media coverage of the Iraq War. Phil Donahue's 2002 program Donahue was canceled in late February 2003 during the build-up to the Iraq War despite earlier claims of cancellation because of low ratings. Donahue was MSNBC's highest-rated show that month. A leaked NBC internal study revealed that the studio was concerned that Donahue would act as a home for the liberal anti-war agenda at the same time that our competitors are waving the flag at every opportunity. Rise of the New Right documentary in June 2010, a documentary airing on MSNBC and hosted by Chris Matthews called Rise of the New Right drew significant criticism from some conservatives and the Tea Party movement. The documentary features interviews with Dick Armey, the former House Majority Leader, Orly Tates, a leading figure in the birther movement, and radio host Alex Jones. The documentary also showed the Michigan Militia's survival training camp and hit the campaign trail with Kentucky senatorial candidate Rand Paul after the documentary aired. FreedomWorks, chaired by Armey, issued a letter calling for a boycott of Don and Proctor. Matthews. The boycott was ineffective. Proctor segment on her show featured a picture of former Republican presidential candidate Mitt Romney and his extended family. Mr. Romney was holding on his knee his adopted grandchild, Kieran Romney, and African-American Harris Perry and her guests, including actress Pia Glenn and comedian Dean Obidala, joked about coming up with captions for the photo. Glenn sang out, "One of these things is not like the others, one of these things just isn't the same. Obidala said, it sums up the diversity of the Republican Party and the Republican National Committee, where they have the whole convention and they find the one black person afterwards. Harris Perry issued an apology in a series of tweets anti-Israel bias. MSNBC has repeatedly been accused of airing material, including inaccurate maps, that some observers regard as anti-Israel. Suspensions of hosts Michael Savage during the spring and early summer of 2003. MSNBC featured a weekend talk show hosted by conservative radio host Michael Savage in July of that year. Savage responded to a prank caller on his show by calling him a pig and a sodomite, and telling him he should get AIDS and die. Savage's show was cancelled and Savage was fired from the channel shortly afterward, with some reports placing the termination immediately after the episode in question ended. Don Imus. In early April 2007, Don Imus, whose radio show Imus in the Morning was simulcast on MSNBC for over 10 years, described members of the Rutgers University women's basketball team as some nappy-headed hoes. The comments sparked outrage, as many considered them to be racist and sexist after sponsors began to withdraw advertisements from the show. MSNBC canceled the simulcast Imus, as well as NBC News, apologized to the Rutgers basketball team for the remarks. The television simulcast of Don Imus' program later moved to RFD-TV until August 2009 and then to Fox Business Network until May 2015. Keith Olbermann. On November 5, 2010, MSNBC President Phil Griffin suspended Keith Olbermann indefinitely without pay for contributing $2,400, the maximum personal donation limit, to each of three Democratic candidates during the 2010 midterm election cycle. Contributions to political campaigns, under NBC News policy, are not allowed without prior permission. On November 7, 2010, Olbermann posted a thank you message to supporters via Twitter that same day. MSNBC announced that he would be back in the air starting on November 9. 2 weeks later, Griffin announced the suspension of Joe Scarborough for the same offense, as the Morning Joe host had donated $4,000 to Republican candidates in Florida. Like Olbermann's suspension, Scarborough's suspension was brief, and he returned to the airwaves on November 24. On January 21, 2011, MSNBC announced that Olbermann would host his final show that same night. Martin Bashir. Host Martin Bashir resigned after making a controversial comment about Sarah Palin on November 15, 2013. Bashir criticized Palin for comments that she made comparing the federal debt to slavery. Bashir attempted to counter Palin's comparison by referencing the cruel and barbaric punishment of slaves described by slave overseer Thomas Thistlewood, specifically a punishment called Derby's Dose, which involved forcing slaves to defecate or urinate into the mouth of another slave as punishment. Bashir then concluded by saying, when Mrs. Palin invokes slavery, she doesn't just prove her rank ignorance, she confirms if anyone truly qualified for a dose of discipline from Thomas Thistlewood, she would be the outstanding candidate. Alec Baldwin. Alec Baldwin's 2013 show Up Late with Alec Baldwin was suspended after 5 episodes due to a homophobic slur Baldwin made to a photographer in New York City. References Carrot. ABMSNBC signs on with Sirius XM Radio, news channel to debut on satellite service April 12. Multichannel news April 7, 2010. Carrot. Stelter, Brian. October 6, 2010. MSNBC on the web may change its name. The New York Times. News beat CNN. ISBN. The 28th of August 2008. Carrot. ABC. MSNBC beats CNN in 1Q 2010 in primetime, and in total day among adults in March, first time since 2001. TV by the numbers, retrieved 31 March 2010. Carrot. AB. MSNBC beats CNN in total day in 3Q among A25-54, first time since 2Q 2001. TV by the numbers, retrieved 10 September 2010. Carrot. AB. Phil Griffin, Lean Forward campaign is going to define us as MSNBC Media Bistro, retrieved 13 October 2010. Carrot. AB. MSNBC to Lean Forward in 2-year brand campaign. MSNBC retrieved 13 October 2010. Carrot. AB. MSNBC com may change its name. The New York Times, retrieved 14 October 2010. Carrot. AB. NBC News takes back MSNBC com from Microsoft Broadcasting. Times. Multichannel News. Multichannel.com, retrieved 30 July 2010. ABC cable channel nods to ratings and leans left. The New York Times published November 6, 2007, retrieved August 24, 2008. Bar, Andy, 5 April 2011. MSNBC host coaxes Ron Paul to run. Politico, Kernotsky, Steve, 21 January 2011. Is Olbermann the victim of his own success? Salon.com, Olbermann talks office politics, other politics. MediaBistro.com, January 10, 2008. Retrieved the 16th of September 2009. Miller, Emily, the 8th of October 2010. NBC flees from lefty MSNBC cable network. Human Events, retrieved the 11th of October 2010. Journalismorg, the 29th of October 2008, retrieved the 30th of July 2010. The final days of the media campaign 2012, final weeks in the mainstream press. Press release, Pew Research Center's Project for Excellence in Journalism, November 19, 2012, retrieved November 20, 2012.